am Dr. 언영차. The author of Bible Matrix 7, Historical and Scientific Views on Daniel and Revelation, Part 2, Revelation. Please let me start to Revelation 1:A. Who is, and who was, and who is to come? The Almighty. Please read Revelation 1:A. As I already mentioned in Bible Matrix 7:97, the scope of Revelation covers the past, the present, and the future. So it is very hard to understand. The reason why I think that the scope includes the past, the present, and the future is that God the Father, who was, and who is, and who is to come are recorded in Revelation 1:4, 1:8, and 4:8. Which means the past, the present, and the future. Chapter 1 of Revelation covers the past, the present, and the future. And chapter 2 and 3 cover the seven churches of the past, the present, and the future. And mostly from the chapter 4 to 22 is the future. Around AD 8580 to 12900. So, its understanding is beyond my knowledge of history, science, and technology. Therefore, I will interpret and explain all the events in Revelation according to the time matrix I had said in my previous session of Bible Matrix 7:97, and I will try to interpret Revelation with the knowledge of history, science, and technology I have learned so far. Please see the time matrix as follows. The last word of Revelation 1:A is the Almighty, which in Hebrew is El Shaddai, which means God Almighty. I will follow the time matrix of the past, the present, and the future. Daniel prophesied the past and the future in a rather complicated way, but Revelation prophesied the future in some time series, such as the before the last one, 7, right here. During the last one, 7, right here. And after the last one, 7. Right here. I will introduce them more in detail as I move forward. Next topic is Revelation 1:9. I, John, was on the island of Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. Thanks for your listening. See you next time. Bye bye.